He was voted the favorite tournament organizer at the Philly Awards at Brotherly Love the End, and definitely well deserved. He's one of the better guys that the Philadelphia region has to offer. Jones, the 28th seed in this bracket, relative unknown, but that also is the wild card factor that could work in his favor, because Deli, he doesn't know what to expect.
Yeah, you don't know what to expect when you're going against these randoms and pools, especially in Smash 4. Because, as we all know, if you play Smash for long enough, you're bound to get blown up. It can happen anytime, to anyone, in any place. No one's immune. We've seen even the best players fall in round one pools to relative no-names and have close sets with much more people than that.
You're absolutely right. I mean, lest we forget, it's Super Smash Con, Nairo falling out at right before day three, even. Relatively early on, not the placement that he wanted. But that's the nature of the game. That's why they play the games, as Yogi Berra once said. So it's one of those things that you can't really help sometimes, but at the same time, it is the nature of the beast. Deli and Jones. Jones looking to see if he can put his name on the map against one of the more established players that the Philadelphia region has to offer. Now, what are you expecting from Deli at this point?
Well, this is a big spoil on the screen. We're going to get a Korin ditto. Male versus female. Whoever's playing female Korin has to win, because I do not like any of the male Korin players, so do for justice, please. Please, God.
It's looking like it will be Deli playing male Korin, so way to establish your bias right up top.
Oh, no, Slash is playing male Korin. See?
Oh, right, Slashy, there we go.
Yeah. All right, so Smashville, another ditto on Smashville. There's not really a whole lot you can say here. We know what Korin does. Good at, even though her mobility is not, you know, leaves a lot to be desired, very good at locking characters down with Instapin, with her disjointed aerials, stuff like that. Setting up landing traps with Dragon Fang. Oh, nice pin right there on the landing.
Good stuff, and a good option to go backwards to get back on stage, establish control. And yeah, that's the thing. Korin, very much a character that establishes the flow of the game. Very disruptive character in that regard. So it's one of those things that lets you kind of slow down the pace and gives you a, oh my gosh, good temper pin in the air by Slashy, who is asserting himself quite well, although he will lose that stock there.
Yeah, I think the rogue down air from Deli just kind of threw him off to the point where he didn't know what to do. Probably lost his resources in that instance, trying to go for a landing trap or something. Who knows? By the way, Deli's got the lead, putting on a clean 48% and going.
Now, we have seen Deli do quite well before in tournaments. A halfway decent showing last night, where he went down in the bracket to Yoda Cage eventually, the seventh ranked in PR and resident Morton main. A Slashy does take the first stock off of him finally, sitting at 67%. Deli got taken out by Yoda Cage in winners round three, so no shame in that. The best damn Morton on the East Coast, as he calls himself.
He's the only one on the East Coast. He's allowed to do that.
Well, there you go. So there's truth in advertising, let me tell you.
I mean, I'll give him that.
And an incredibly exhilarating set loses round six, where he got taken out by Beast, who eventually earned himself a berth in the grand finals, and going on an incredible win streak in the loser's side of the bracket, a five-game win streak before getting taken out by Juice, who, again, waiting in winners round two with that bye.
And as we were explaining all of Deli's accolades right there, he just ran away with game one, only 40% on him on the second stock. The back you're taking it from. Center stays, and DI looked a little bit suspect. Probably didn't expect to get hit by it. Either way, got to throw the game away, move into game two. And
I mean,
expect to see the Korin Diddle stay strong. I don't know if these. I don't know if Slash has any other characters. I know Deli does, but I don't think he wants to switch after a game like that.
Well, Deli is one of those guys. I mean, I was about to say characters. He is a character
He's
in some regards,
character.
I'll say that. But definitely one of those guys that takes into account spacing, and that's just traditional Fire Emblem character play that emphasizes spacing so much. I think we are going to see a switch. He's switching to King Dedede, the same Dedede that took Beast to task in Losers Round 6. How will he fare here? All hail the King, says Deli, as we go to Final Destination for Game 2.
I think this is actually like a... not so much a matchup thing, but a matchup experience thing. Not a lot of people are going to have DD practice. Not a lot of people are going to know exactly what's coming at them when DD, you know, runs out the gate, right? Like,
yeah.
Like Slashy doesn't know that at this position right now, DD is a top 15 character. When he has you on ledge, all the options are busted. He can set up Gordo. He can use all those smash attacks to cover what you do to get around Gordo. He can cover your jump with aerials. Like it's just insane. But then at this point, when you actually hit DD, when you make him try to get to that advantage state, that's when he falters. That's where he kind of drops down to the bottom of the series today.
You're absolutely right, and not to mention that Gordo off of the ledge. Slashy will get the recovery as well as the reflecting the second Gordo back at Deli. But DDD, again, I mean, Deli, I was about to say Deli, King DDD, a character that has some disruptive elements of his own, again, with that Gordo. Slashy going to take a trade off of that. It's one of those things that, yeah, you're absolutely right. A character that you're not used to facing can present a matchup nightmare.
Oh, that was good edgeguard right there. But he could probably lift that. Yeah, just back. Deli not putting out any effort to extend the edgeguard, but he needs to wrap up the stock before Khan.
Oh, good stuff by Deli to take the first stock. He's sitting at 101, but if he can pile on some damage here, I think that he'll take the loss of stock. Although Slashy playing very well defensively, getting that back air, zoning himself out. So playing very smart, just trying to get that first stock off of him so he can get back to even.
Yep. But Deli's not going to let him do that, hopefully. F-Smash very stale at this point. DDD very fat, no raise on Corrin either. So Deli lives with a lot of room to spare. All right.
Sitting at 27%. Yeah, that neutral B will take the first stock. So Slashy winds up pulling himself back. He's not in a terrible position at all. But he might be letting himself get comboed. Invincibility frames definitely helping Slashy there.
Oh, I like this, the command grab. Free 11% on the roll-in. Just reset the ledge situation as well. Now he's back at the ledge. Nice fight right there. Jumping off, throwing out the fair, smacking Gordo away, and then hitting Deli when he tries to come in.
Sitting at 81% right now, Deli playing extremely patiently, picking his spots very well.
Dead.
And those up airs, he's not dead quite yet. DI. Excellent DI.
That was actually...
Oh, and off of the ledge! Get stomped on, says Deli. Slashy will get the recovery as well as the invincibility frames, but that down smash could very well do it. He's sitting at 153. The Gordo, Slashy will not stay down, and he gets back to the stage in neutral. Trying to steal a stock from off of Deli. He survives! Slashy rises from the dead to take game two.
What was that?
That was incredible. Excellent stuff by Slashy.
I've never seen that before. I also would have died. He got Dare Footstool. Like, what? Like, I know she can do that if she's so high up, but I didn't expect in that exact moment at 28% or something of that nature, Dare Footstool to steal the game.
Absolutely. Oh, my gosh. Deli just got his pocket picked. I mean, that Corrin's sitting at 164%, and don't get me wrong, Corrin is a relatively difficult character to kill. We see Juice, in particular, stock tank with it quite a lot in doubles play. But, man, oh man, that Dare, but he knew that he had to get something cheeky, and boy, oh boy, did he get it.
He had to pull out the entire wild card right there. He knew he had to do it, and he went for it, and it paid off for him big time because he's still alive in the set. We're going to Smash Bowl 4, Game 3. Deli going to stick with the King DDD, and now I expect to see a different beast out of Deli in this game because I saw a lot of dropped opportunities that against a lot of other players that I know he would have tried to cover, but he just didn't cover it because I feel like he felt like he didn't need to. But now, back against the ropes, you're about to get upset in pools. Can't have that happen. Not when you're protected from mid-top B.
But I do see Slashy finding a flow for himself, although he does get tagged by the Gordo there. That was really the first hit that he suffered from a Gordo this whole match. And a quick first stock within the first 35 seconds. And Deli definitely looking to make up for lost ground. He's sitting at only 33% right now. So again, a decent position to be in. Shields the neutral B. Oh yeah, Deli is looking to make a statement here. Slashy just trying to get back to neutral, eventually does using the spacing tools, but man, Deli playing with absolutely no fear in his heart right now.
Yup. Like I predicted, he's just...
Gets tagged by the Gordo! Excellent stuff!
He really threw the Gordo back. And that covers the high recovery with the up air, put Slashy back off stage, another up air, now Slashy's back on stage. But he had to take so much damage just to get there. He's got to get the stock off about now.
Yeah, I mean, playing a little Gordo tennis are these two, but ultimately you got to start playing some Smash, and Slashy trying to get back to the proceedings, use whatever he can, but he's letting Deli get far too close, and again, that hammer is so disruptive and presents some spacing problems for Slashy as well.
Yep. Goes to Gordo just to cover himself coming back to the ledge. Now Deli is back at center stage, but Slashy hits the down tilt, tries to read the air dodge, but Deli's just going to fight his way back down. Not going to give him the air dodge he's looking for. Now both players are sitting at above 100%, but Slashy's a whole stock behind. Both of them just looking for the Kimu's eliminating stocks.
Oh, Deli just daring him to go over to the ledge, and he does, but he gets a grab as a thank you. Oh, he was looking for the smash.
That's what he gets. Try and jet hammer in that situation. There was no reason to even try that. Oh, your shield.
Oh, forward smash to break the shield, and that is going to do it. Deli drops the hammer, and that's going to do it for game three. Deli moves on in the winner's side of the bracket. He will be moving on to winner's semifinal action in that quarterfinal match. Good stuff by Slashy to survive, and I mean that was a little closer than we might have expected.
Definitely, yeah. I wasn't expecting a game three at all, but like we saw in the game three, Deli, he fine-tuned his game plan from games one and two. Really turned it up to a next level. Slashy couldn't keep up, so he's going to be moving on. Slashy's going to have to fight his way through losers if he wants to make top 8 tomorrow. And as quickly as that set ended, we're going to get another one on stream right now. We have Earthboundy and Red Nova.
Red Nova, absolutely. Now, Earthboundy, a familiar face to those of us at the laboratory. As his name would suggest, he is a Nest main. Red Nova has gone, has already won a game in bracket versus Shass. And here he is taking on Earthboundy. So he is a guy who competed at Summer Jam 11 last year, placing 5th out of the 16 competitors. Noticeably absent in the field this year is Lord Xavier, who wound up winning Summer Jam 11. And we certainly wish you the best if you are out there, Lord Xavier. We miss you here at the Crown Plaza in Cherry Hill, New Jersey. But hey, you know what? It's the biggest party of the summer. Got to celebrate with the friends we got. You know what I'm saying, Dom? Well,
can reminisce on the people that aren't here. We just have to appreciate the people that are here. And what we do have here is a
Yo, we hitting the club after this, by the way.
Are we?